Welcome to Beyond the Press channel.
Hello.
I'm Lauri.
And I'm Anni.
And here we have over 4 tons of steel. And you have been asking for videos with the bigger milling machine and the big lathe. And today we have something really big to do. Or we are not going to do anything. It's the guys working on the workshop. But yeah, this is going to be huge rock drill. And it's going to take many hours and we have to probably remove like 1 ton of material. So it's going to be a really interesting video. And I think we are going to first load it in to the workshop and then it goes to the milling machine. And after that to lathe and back to milling machine. And then it gets hardened and everything. So here we go. Okay, so here we are on the first round with the milling machine. And I would have to warn that I didn't have a huge amount of time to use for this video because we were filming the Kronos ring stuff when this was happening. So I mainly just brought some cameras in the morning on the machines and kept them on for the whole day. But I managed to film almost all the steps of the project. So I think it's turned out pretty well. And on the first round of the milling machine, the goal was to make it possible to mount the piece on the big lathe really well for the major of the turning process. And that needs to make, and for that we need to make the both ends smooth and level, make the center hole for the support bearing. And also we made the another end like round for jaws on the chuck. And now it's on the lathe. And it's really hard to machine because it's like, it's really high strength steel and it's forced. So the surface was really uneven and hard and we end up going through really many like cutting bits. But now it's done and then the finishing cut with the lathe. And at this point there's at least 1/2 ton of material already removed. So quite a lot of work done in short amount of time on the video. And after this, the lathe stuff is all about done. And we can only thing that is missing is the center hole. And because this is drill, rock drill, they have to feed like some kind of fluid, coolant and to like, I think it cools and like pushes all the material out under from under the drill. So we have to make hole for that. And first there is like starter hole on middle of the thing. And then we are going to get really long drill that is going to make the rest of the thing. And there is coolant thing on middle of that drill. Exactly on the big drill also that feeds the coolant on the like end of the drill, so we can get all the shavings out and cool the drill. And this was pretty fast drill. It has like some kind of tungsten carbide in the like changeable bit on end of that steel holder. And of course this video is sped up, so it isn't this fast in the real life. but still like reasonable fast and much faster than your regular like high speed steel drill would be, especially on hard material like this. And as you can see, there is some flex on the thing and the sound is pretty terrible. It like makes this like shaking sound like really bad. You can hear it even like from outside of the shop. So not pleasant at all. But if you don't count the sound, it's otherwise pretty like easy step, I think. And then the hole has to be machined at the right size. I think that's the right size has to be only on like this end on the middle. It doesn't matter what size the hole really is. So you don't have to machine the hole on the exact diameter. And then we get the Edward back to the milling machine. And there is a lot of different shapes that to be machined there, because the drill has to be mounted on the machine that spins it. And then there is going to be also like larger ring on end of the drill, because the larger diameters wear faster. So I think the drill goes through many like outer rings before the main body has to be changed. So I think these shapes are for mounting those outside rings that are even larger than the drill itself in diameter. And I got out the like tool bit changes from this part. It's still really hard material and the tool bit doesn't last really long. And there is quite a lot of material to be removed. There is like 6 of those on each of the drills. And then on the end surface there has to be also some shapes there. I think these are for the coolant or the like fluid. And now we are going to drill holes that connect the center hole with these like shapes and let the fluid flow there on the like surface of the drill. And first you have to make it even, and then you have to make the starter hole, and now we have the like main drill that we are going to use. And it's just regular high speed steel drill, but we have the drill sharpener, so if it gets dull we can just like take 0.5 millimeter away or less and it's good as new. So they work pretty well for this. It doesn't take super long because the distance that we have to drill isn't that great. And after this part the drill is almost done, and then it goes to hardening facility and it gets heat treated. And after that we are going to make small holes for the whole face to be full. But I didn't have time to film that, I was somewhere when that happened. So here it is. Big ass rock drill. Yeah, and I think this is the one of the like coolest and most interesting things that we usually make. We make like maybe 3 or 4 of these per year, and then a lot of the wear rings that are going to be installed around these. We make the rings that we make, they are bits for a bit smaller rings. We don't make the rings for this size. I think I can make sometimes video about the rings also. But usually the main problem with the large machining projects like this is just the thing that they took like week or more to do. So I can't film one YouTube video for 1 week. I don't have time for that. But I think I try to make more videos with the big machines, because I think there isn't much footage like this on YouTube. And even with this amount of effort, I think the video turned out to be really interesting. And the amount of material we removed from the drill was really large. I think there was something like probably 6 containers of the shavings. And the total mass of the removed material was probably well over 1 ton. And we went through many, many cut bits, so lot of time and lot of tool costs in making stuff like this. Yeah, but I think that is all for today. Thank you for watching and have a nice day.